Is this your card? Hey guys, I'm Joseph and I just watched Now You See Me 2. Alright my peeps, Now You See Me 2 is an enjoyable movie. It's fun to watch and the tricks and the magic in the movie are just as good as the first one. So definitely, I mean, it was awesome to watch. The tricks, the magic is all amazing. But I think this movie falls a bit short when it comes to the actual story, because in the first one, I mean, it was brand new and it was crazy and it was intense. And the whole entire time you're trying to figure out, like, who's behind something. So you had, like, that big reveal. Where in this one, there was, like, an attempt to, like, a semi-big reveal, but it didn't quite hit. And the actual story gives you some closure on some backstory, and we get a little bit more of, like, the eye involvement, but it's still, like, the eye is so out there, kind of, so it's kind of hard to bring it into the movie. So I feel like they're trying to give us more eye, but we don't. It's not done in a way that makes it, like, super easy to understandable, because it's kind of wishy-washy. But also, the very beginning of the movie is just a memory, which kind of gives us a detailed look at something that we were told in the first movie. I don't want to say it, because I don't want to ruin or spoil the movie. I think what this movie really lacked was, like, an awe moment, because it felt good, it was cool to watch, like I said, it was enjoyable, you're entertained. But it never really, like, really takes you, or you're never really, like, yes, or something like that, other than the moments where you see the magic, because the magic is awesome. But I felt like it was kind of lacking what we got in the first movie, so it was kind of iffy. And when you finally find out who was really helping the horsemen the whole time in the first movie, you're like, I knew it, or you're like, I was wrong, I guess it was the other person. So this one, I felt like they tried to give us a small moment like that, but it didn't hit as, I guess, as big, or didn't have an impact quite as big as the first time. But like I said, the movie looks awesome. It was fun to watch. The characters are still awesome. And the story wasn't horrible. It was actually pretty good and a good continuance from the first one. It was just something that didn't quite, I guess, appeal as much or really pull you in. So one scene which was awesome to see, I mean, it was awesome. But I think it only kind of hurt the story, because in that scene, they don't do anything. It's just, it's cool and awesome, but completely unnecessary. It kind of stops the movie just so you can be like, check this out guys, we can do this, and they do something awesome, and then it's over, and then the movie continues. So I was kind of like, all right, cool, that was awesome and I liked watching it, but it was, we didn't need it, we didn't need you doing all that good stuff, so it kind of hurts. So I think the horsemen, of course, did a great job. The only issues I did have was the new character, Lula. She's good and she has funny moments, but there's moments where she kind of gets annoying, or it's just like too much. I'm just like, nah, I'm not really digging it, or I'm not really involved with that character. I like all the other ones, you know, from the first one to even now, they're still just as awesome. Your character has moments where I'm like, haha, I like her, and there's moments where I'm like, next, go back to somebody else. So that was one of the issues I had there. Of course, Merritt, we meet his twin brother in this movie. Merritt is Woody Harrelson. But his twin brother is played also by Woody Harrelson. And it was funny at first, but then it kind of just got also a little bit annoying and kind of boring. And I was kind of like, I see what you're trying to do, but it worked. And then it kind of just dulled out. So those are a couple issues I had with a couple characters, but nothing super crazy. Like I said, the movie itself is very enjoyable. I liked it. It's something you could rewatch, but it's not something I'd rewatch in a theater. Maybe when it comes out on TV or Netflix or something like that, I'd be like, yeah, let's watch it. So, like I said, enjoyable. The magic, again, is awesome. I think the magic may look or may be just as awesome as the first, but still, I feel like it dragged in some parts, like it was delayed or just slowed down a little too much for the movie itself. All in all, I'm giving Now You See Me 2 a C. Like I said, the movie is enjoyable, but it's not quite as good as the first, which, you know, sequels are hard to do that. But it was good. It's just not, like, the first movie on the list of movies to watch this weekend. I'm not like, I have to see it or I have to see it again. It's kind of like, cool, I'm glad I saw it. And it looks like we might get a third one, which I'll see. And still, you know, hopeful it's better than this one. But it looks like they're kind of setting up to give us a third one. We don't quite know yet if we're going to get it, but we'll see how this goes. All right, guys, don't forget to smash that like button for me. And if you want to see more, you're going to want to click right here. And as always, it's a pleasure.
We'll be right back.